Hi, astronomers. Caroline here. Earth is a pretty great place to live. We've got water and energy resources, and the Earth's temperature and surface supports life. However, since landing on the moon became a reality in 1969, we began to wonder if we could visit or even live on other planets. Although living on another planet is a definite possibility in the future, maybe we should start by sending crewed missions to another planet first. Which planet would allow us to have the most successful crewed mission? In order to answer that question, we're going to need to know more about each of the planets. In the next few lessons, we'll explore the characteristics of the planets to help us decide where scientists should plan to send our next crewed mission. Today, we're going to focus on the two planets closest to the Sun, Mercury and Venus. By the end of this lesson, you'll be able to compare and contrast key characteristics of Mercury and Venus with Earth and explain why each of these terrestrial planets has its own unique properties. Let's get started. What are the planets closest to the Sun? Do they have anything in common? Pause the video and make a prediction on your note sheet. The four planets closest to the Sun are terrestrial planets. Terrestrial planets are smaller in size and have hard and rocky surfaces that we could land on. Under the hard crust of the terrestrial planets, you'll find a dense core made of heavy metals. Let's take a closer look at the closest terrestrial planets, Mercury and Venus. Mercury is the smallest planet in our solar system, about the size of our moon. Also, like our moon, it has craters that were formed when meteoroids and comets crashed into its surface. If Mercury has so many impact craters, what does that tell you about its atmosphere? Again, similar to the moon, Mercury only has a thin exosphere surrounding it. It can't really trap heat like our atmosphere. So, with what we know about the conditions on the moon and how close Mercury is to the Sun, what do you think the temperature might be like there? What about the side that's facing away from the Sun when it's nighttime on Mercury? Go ahead and pause the video and make a prediction in your notes. Even though it's the closest to the Sun, Mercury is not the hottest planet. Without an atmosphere, the planet experiences extreme temperature changes, so it gets very hot and very cold. The side of Mercury that is facing the Sun can reach over 400 degrees Fahrenheit, and the side facing away can drop to almost negative 247 degrees Fahrenheit. Those hot days on Mercury last longer than Earth days. Mercury takes 59 Earth days to rotate once on its axis. This means it stays day for a whole month, then night for a whole month, before the sun rises again. On the other hand, a year on Mercury is faster than on Earth. Why do you think the years are so short? Because it is so close to the sun, Mercury completes a revolution every 88 days. And because Mercury's axis has almost no tilt, the weather stays consistent all year. Considering that the daytime temperatures on Mercury are about four times the temperature that humans can survive at, Mercury is probably not our best choice for a mission. Now that we've got a good idea of what it's like on Mercury, let's take a look at the next planet from the Sun, sometimes referred to as Earth's evil twin, Venus. Venus is about the same size as Earth. If you look up at the night sky, Venus is one of the planets that is visible without a telescope, both because it's our neighbor and because it's very bright. But Venus's evil nature begins to show when we look closer at its surface and atmosphere. Although Venus has a rocky surface, 85% of it is covered in active volcanoes. Looking up, we'll see cloud cover. but these clouds are a bit different. Instead of being made of water vapor, they're made of sulfuric acid. The atmosphere above them is thick and creates immense pressure. The thick atmosphere is one more thing on Venus that contributes to its bad reputation. What do you think the temperature is like on Venus? Keep in mind how the thin atmosphere impacts the temperatures on Mercury, and how Earth's atmosphere keeps our temperature in the life-sustaining range. Pause the video and record your prediction in your notes. Even though Mercury is closer to the Sun, Venus's thick atmosphere is what makes it the hottest planet. Missions to Venus have measured temperatures reaching 800 degrees Fahrenheit. But why does the thick atmosphere make the temperature so hot that it can melt lead? Remember that certain gases in the atmosphere, like carbon dioxide, can trap heat. On Venus, the thick atmosphere is almost entirely carbon dioxide. Because of the high level of this greenhouse gas, heat cannot escape. These smoking hot temperatures persist both day and night, since it's the atmosphere causing the heat, not which way the planet is facing due to rotation or tilt. Speaking of days and nights, Venus is a bit unique. What do you notice about how Venus is rotating compared to Mercury and Earth? Venus rotates the opposite direction. This means the Sun rises in the west and sets in the east. To add to the peculiarity, one day on Venus is 243 Earth days, while a year is 225 Earth days. This means a day on Venus is longer than a year. Now, if we did manage to invent spacesuits that could withstand the heat, what about gravity? Gravity is the force of attraction between matter, in this case, between the astronaut and the planet. Remember, Mercury is about the size of our moon, and Venus is about the size of Earth. So, would we actually be able to stand on each, or would we float away? Pause your video and record your prediction. Since the mass of Venus is just a bit smaller than Earth's, the gravity on Venus is about 91% of the gravity of Earth. Mercury only has about 38% of the gravity Earth does because of its small size. So standing on Venus, you'd weigh a bit less than you do here on Earth, but on Mercury, you'd weigh a lot less. This means you'd be able to bounce around on Mercury as you explored, which sounds pretty fun to me. You now know that Mercury and Venus, like Earth, are terrestrial planets with hard rocky surfaces close to the Sun. Since it has no atmosphere, Mercury is covered in impact craters and has large temperature fluctuations. Venus is similar in size to Earth and has an active volcanic surface. Due to its thick atmosphere, Venus is extremely hot all of the time. So although they're both terrestrial planets and show evidence of water, it's pretty clear that the temperatures of Mercury and Venus are the main factor preventing crewed missions to these planets with our current technology. But scientists are always making new discoveries, and engineers are always inventing new solutions. So that means we never know what the future will hold. You can explore more about Mercury and Venus and the data that scientists have collected in the additional activities for this lesson. And in our next lessons, we'll keep exploring the other planets. Hopefully one of them is more promising for a crewed mission. And always remember, you are out of this world. See you next time!